Hey everyone, it's Ashley. Thanks so much for joining me again today on my channel. I'm so excited to help Altenew roll out their three newest ink collections for you. Each of these collections have four colors in it that go from lightest to darkest, and I thought that it would be really fun to show you a few different ways that you can use sets like this in your card making. This first example is very much inspired by Christina Werner's recent faux dip dyed watercolor video. Now, I'm not going to go too much into the specifics of how to create a faux dip dyed look because Christina has already done that flawlessly in her video. So I'm going to link that video in the description, but I do want to show you how I take these inks and make them into watercolors. So I'm going to be using the blue range of inks for this first technique. So we've got from lightest to darkest, Misty Morning, Cloudy Sky, Nimbus, and Dark Night. I'm going to roll out my Altenew stamping mat here because I want you to be able to see where I place the ink a little bit better than on my glass mat. So I'm going to first use my lightest, which is Misty Morning. You can see I have a square flat edge paintbrush there and some clean water. So I'm going to follow Christina's directions pretty specifically and use my lightest color to my darkest. Now what I'm going to do, and as you saw, was I just went ahead and pressed my ink pad onto this mat. Now again, I'm using the white mat, the stamping mat for this, so that you can see it sort of come to life. On the black mat, it would be a little bit tough to see, but when I press onto the mat, I obviously get some ink transfer. So I do that a few times just to make sure that I get a nice buildup of ink, and then I use some clean water to create a little bit more of a watercolor rather than an ink. This dye ink is just a bit thicker and doesn't move around as easily. So if you add a little bit of water to it, it pretty much becomes a very fun and different type of watercolor. So if you want a lot of vibrancy, you might want to add a little bit extra ink to it, which you can absolutely do. But these dye inks turn into watercolors really easily and simply in this manner, just by adding a little bit of water to it. So now that I've taken this off, you can see that I've also created a purple one with the purple line of inks, and I'll show you those inks in just a minute. But this is the card that I created. I just went ahead and stamped some floral images from the flower garden set onto the bottom, and then used a really simple sentiment strip there on the bottom, and I think that it just looks really understated and really pretty. For my next example, I'll be using these inks for layered stamping, which is of course one of the most common ways to use a set of inks like this. I'm going to be using the Sunflower Daisy set because it's one of my favorite layered sets from Altenew. I just feel like it looks so realistic when it's all stamped out and done, and I wanted to show you how this specific color scheme can work really well with this stamp. For this yellow line of inks, our colors from lightest to darkest are Butternut, Pumpkin Pie, Yellow Ochre, and Sicilian Amber. So now I'm adding the darkest shade in for the most detailed on the flower, which is Sicilian Amber. And once I go ahead and stamp that, you can see that we just have so much color and dimension and shadows, and I just absolutely love that. So for the center of the flower, I'm going to show when I stamp the third layer, which is the last layer for the center, because I feel like this layer really is what brings it all together for me, and as far as being so realistic, and that's probably my favorite layer of the entire set. So I'm going to show you actually how I used that at the end of the video, because I incorporate it a little bit in with another card that I make. For my next example, I'm going to be ink blending. Now, I love using sets of inks like these for ink blending because it takes the guesswork out of what blends in with what. So I'm going to be creating, in this example, a glowing scene from the center out. So for these purple colors, we have Pale Mauve, Amethyst, grape agate, and plum. So I'm going from the darkest on the very outer edges of my cardstock to the center, and I'm working my way down from darkest to lightest. So this is a little bit different than what we've been doing for the rest of the techniques, working from lightest to darkest. I do this because if I start in the center with my lightest, it's pretty definite that I'm going to get some lines going from lightest to dark when you're blending. So if you go from darkest to lightest, you have a little bit more wiggle room. So I've used the same concept and actually created this ink blended card, which actually is ombre from the top to bottom. So it goes from darkest to lightest from the top to the bottom. And I've added a dodec star die cut there in the center just to sort of represent a snowflake. And I love the way that that one came out. It was super easy to create, and these colors really just made the whole thing pop. For my final example, I am actually pretty blown away that I'm able to do this with this felt pad. Now, I don't have a ton of luck with this ink swiping or pad to paper technique with felt pads. I had my friend Jen over the other day, who is the co-founder of AltNew, and I told her how much I love doing this with foam pads, and she said, you have to try it with the full-size AltNew ink pads, because they work wonderfully. And she was absolutely right. I love how this turned out. They worked so well. So what I did was created this ombre panel with a pad to paper technique. And after making the panel go from lightest to darkest, I actually used the dodec cover plate die to cut out and make this really beautiful design. You can see there I used a couple pieces of that sunflower daisy stamp set as well. I was really blown away with how well this technique worked with the AltNew felt ink pads, and I hope that you'll try it. I want to thank you again for stopping by today. As always, all of the links to the products mentioned are in the description, as well as a link to my blog post, which is part of today's blog hop. Thanks so much for stopping by. Please hit that subscribe button, and I'll see you again.